testing hip extension against gravity position, patient will be prone. For this, we'll be testing two different muscles, the hamstrings and the gluteus maximus. We'll first test the hamstrings. First thing I will want my patient to do is to bring her hip all the way into extension while keeping the knee into extension as well. So go ahead and bring that hip all the way back from your ridge and then back down. I will classify that as a 3. Now to test for a 4 or a 5, what I will do is I will stabilize here up at the hip, and then I will add resistance just proximal to the knee here. So bring that up again about halfway, or add resistance, 3, 2, 1, bring it back down. Keep in mind these are big muscles, so I'm going to put quite a bit of resistance on them. Okay, now I will test for the gluteus maximus. So I want you to bend your knee, Rachel, okay, and then perform full hip extension again while with the knee bent. Go all the way up and back down. That is a 3 once again. To test for a 4 or 5, I will stabilize at the hip again. Come up again, Rachel. I'm gonna add resistance at the same place. Resist, 3, 2, 1, get back down. There we go. That, depending on her resistance, I will classify that as a 4 or a 5. Testing hip extension, gravity eliminated position, patient will be sidelying. We will be testing two different muscles in this. We will be testing the hamstrings and the gluteus maximus. Now we were going to be testing the bottom leg here. So in order for this to go into extension on the table, I will need to support the top leg myself. Support this here. Okay, Rachel, what I want you to do is I want you to bring the bottom leg into hip extension as far as you can go while keeping the knee extended. Okay, now come back. Because there's any movement whatsoever, I'm going to classify that as a 2. If there is no movement, I'm going to palpate the hamstrings here. If I feel these muscles firing, that is a 1. If I do not feel them firing, that is a 0. Now to test for the gluteus maximus, I will have her knee bent and then perform hip extension. Bring that back for me. Because there was movement, that is classified as a 2. If I do not feel any, if there is no movement, I'm going to palpate at the crease here. If I feel the gluteus maximus firing, that is a 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a 0.